So in the lifespan of a smartphone, the Pixel 2 and the Pixel 2 XL are teenagers. It just got their driver's license. It's already been 2 months since these phones came out, which puts it about 20 to 25% already through their life cycle, which is crazy to think about. So I thought we'd revisit the Pixel 2 and the Pixel 2 XL, specifically the XL that I spent a lot of time with, because let's just say it's gotten a lot of press the past few months about the screen, about software. There's been a lot of misconceptions about the device as a whole, and somebody who's used it pretty regularly, I thought I'd share some experiences and how things have changed since the initial review. So I think any revisited with the Pixel 2 XL has got to start with the screen. So if I can back up for a second, the screen that's in the Pixel 2 was actually made by Samsung. It's kind of similar to the screen that was actually in the Note 5. LG got the job of building the screen for the Pixel 2 XL, and so the story gets a little bit weird. There was a lot of complaints that the screen looked blue, that colors didn't look right. What happened essentially was sRGB was turned on out of the box. And despite sRGB, the colors looking more real to life, people are used to these boosted, saturated looking images. So when people looked at the screen on the XL, they were like, this does not look like what I'm used to. When the November update eventually came and you could turn on saturated, the screen looked way better. And I think that Google could have avoided this whole, can I say kerfuffle? They just would have included that out of the box. It would have been a dead story. All the other stuff you'd expect with an OLED display happened. There was some color shift, there was a little bit of a blue tint, and all those things coupled together made people think the screen was a giant steaming pile of garbage. Once saturated finally came, you turned it on, it looked more, and I'm just gonna say it, it looked more Samsung-y, and that's kind of what people got used to. Now, post-November update, I don't think the screen's that bad. Not to say it's the best screen ever put in a smartphone, but it's not as bad as you might think, and I've been using it quite a bit. I think the color representation is really nice. The wide color gamut's there, HDR content looks awesome. It's still not the strong point of the phone, but don't let the screen hold you back from buying it. And I think that's a big difference from what we saw from the first few weeks when the phone was initially announced. So that's the story with the screen. Regardless of how you feel about the display, one thing you can say is the screen is incredible for VR. And I wanna thank the folks at Intel who actually sponsored this video. So everybody knows Intel, but what you might not know is Intel's pretty committed to making VR accessible to absolutely everyone. They recently partnered with filmmaker Eliza McNitt to produce Pale Blue Dot. It's a VR film that kind of takes the audience through the cosmos while letting them totally control the adventure. It's like a choose your own adventure for adults. So Intel's actually released a 5-episode video series that takes you behind the scenes of the making of Pale Blue Dot. You're gonna see how various cinematic tools and tech were used to create this pretty awesome VR experiences like they did in Pale Blue Dot, and how they give creators, like maybe you and me one day, new avenues for storytelling. Click the link in the description box to watch the whole series. Love to know what you guys think. So the screen, I had to get that out of the way. I didn't want to get too much into the science of it or have to worry about burning with OLED displays. It hasn't been an issue for me. I don't think it'll be an issue for you. Something that was an issue in initial review has kind of continued to bother me a little bit with the Pixel 2 XL. Around the display, there is a ridge, and it feels really pronounced as you drag your finger over it. I don't know why it bothers me so much. Maybe I'm more used to the Samsung type phones that have that curve. It's been a small thing that has really kind of annoyed me about the phone. So annoyances aside, I really love the Pixel 2 XL, specifically the camera. I get over almost any annoyance with a little ridge because the cameras are so damn good. And they were good on day one, and because of machine learning that Google loves to talk about, the cameras have gotten even better. Portrait mode shots are awesome. Low light shots are awesome. Normal light shots are awesome. In fact, I haven't really found a situation where the camera is not awesome. It is incredible. And while the screen shouldn't be a reason to have you not buy the phone, the camera should be a reason why you should run to buy the Pixel 2 XL. It is incredible. And not just the rear camera. Although it is a bit odd that there's still one. The front-facing camera also does a nice job with portrait mode, things where the iPhone X has struggled. Not so with the front-facing and the rear-facing cameras on the Pixel 2 XL. It's just damn good. If you can't tell, I really, really love those. The design of the phone, it's still not my jam. I think it's, I wouldn't say like fugly, it's unique, industrial and functional, which I think is probably what the Pixel line is all about. If we're used to Infinity type displays and no bezels, they'd look at this phone and be like, what the hell, Google? But I will say the bezels on the top and the bottom give you two front-facing speakers, and the speakers are really good. You're gonna get some of the best speakers that are on a smartphone, save for what HTC used to do with Boom Sound. So also, having gone from the iPhone back to the Pixel 2 XL, I started to take Quick Charge for granted because it was always on every Android phone I tested, but I didn't opt to spend the extra money because it seemed silly to get Quick Charge on an iPhone. So when I switched back to the Pixel 2 XL and got that Quick Charge, it was super nice. It's not unique to the phone, but I love that it's there. I still wish wireless charging was here, and I get the aluminum back, you can't beat it, but it would have been nice. IP68 also would have been nice, but what the Pixel 2 XL gives you is still a lot in a really good package. So I think the moral that I want to come back to is don't let the reports of the screen stop you from buying the phone. It is an incredible phone in a really good package. It's plenty powerful at the 835 and 4 gigs of RAM. Obviously, 8 gigs of RAM would have been better if you take the OnePlus approach. 6 gigs of RAM would have been better. I haven't had any stutters. I haven't had any issues with things slowing down and multitasking, nothing. I love the pure Android experience that you're getting out of the box. You get the latest version of Android. It's 8.1 as of this filming. It's just a pleasure to use. Battery life has been solid here as well. It's been about the same since my review. It hasn't gotten any better, any worse, but I can easily get through a full day with about 35 to 40% left. So if I push it, I could probably do two-ish days. So for me, that is all that I need. It's a crowded market to pick a new smartphone. There's a lot of things out there. In fact, it's hard to even find a bad smartphone. You look at phones that are over 800 bucks, you're looking at the kings of the smartphone world. You're looking at, obviously, the Pixels, you're looking at the Samsung Note, you're looking at iPhone 10, LG V30. There's a lot of things to choose from. And I think pick up the Pixel 2 XL if you want the best camera you can get on a smartphone. If you want something that's going to work, if you're ensconced in Google's operating systems, it works well. Even if you're not, you can easily become ensconced. I'm sure Google will welcome you, but it's a really good smartphone and perhaps not the most sexy package, but I can still absolutely recommend the Pixel 2 XL. So what you guys gonna say, John, how can you recommend the Pixel 2 XL when you compared it to the iPhone 10 in your last versus video, which you should check out in all the places that we can link stuff. It's an incredible phone and a really good package, but I wanna know your thoughts on it. Do you like the Pixel 2 XL? Did you not like it? Did you buy it? Did you not buy it? Leave them the comments down below, and of course, hit the bell to get notifications so you know when the next Techno Buffalo video is hitting. We have more Pixel videos coming your way. Hope you guys enjoyed. I'm John Rettinger from Techno Buffalo.